Okay, the next type of AP is infinite AP. So, what is infinite AP? If an arithmetic progression or AP does not have a last term, then it is called infinite AP. Okay, let's see an example. Here the AP is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and then it continues. Okay, it can be 100, 102, then 1000, 1002, 1 lakh, 1 lakh 2, and it will go on because it does not have a last term. Hence, it is infinite AP. This is one example of infinite AP. Let's see the second example. Okay, here the first term is 5. Then it is 0, minus 5, minus 10, minus 15, then it will be minus 20, minus 25, and it will continue. There is no last term. These dots, okay, indicates that this AP continues. Okay, this AP continues. Hence it is infinite AP. Okay. Now, next topic is general form of an AP. Okay. You know that in every chapter, like for example, linear equations in two variables, okay, you have a general form. Let us see what is the general form of a pair of linear equations in two variables. Okay, so here the general form is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0, right? Similarly, in AP as well, we have a general form. Okay, and what is the general form of an AP? General form of an AP is a comma a plus d comma a plus 2d comma a plus 3d, and it continues. Okay, so this is what you need to remember. What is the general form of an AP? A comma a plus d comma a plus 2d comma a plus 3d. What does it mean? It means if you have a value of a and a value of d, then you can write the entire AP. Okay, this is the significance of general form of AP. Okay, so what is it? The general form is a comma a plus d comma a plus 2d comma a plus 3d. That means if you are given an AP, you can express it in this form: a comma a plus d comma a plus 2d a plus 3d comma a plus 4d comma a plus 5d, etc. Okay, so let's take an example. So the example is, if a is equal to 10 and d is equal to 5, write the AP. Okay, so if a is given to you and d is given to you, how can you write AP? Okay, so what is the general form of AP? General form of AP is this: a comma a plus d comma a plus 2d a plus 3d and all. So let's substitute the value of a as 10 and d as 5 in this formula and see whether we can get the AP. Okay, so what is the general form? It is a comma, so 10 comma a plus d. What is a? 10. What is d? 5. So 10 plus 5, then comma comma a plus 2d. What is a? 10 plus 2 bracket, 2d means 2 multiplied by d, so d is 5, so 2 into 5 comma a plus 3d. A is 10 plus 3d, d is 5, so 3 into 5, and it continues. So it is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15, comma 10 plus 2 into 5. So 2 into 5 is what? 10. 10 plus 10 is what? 20. So 20, and comma 10 plus 3 into 5 is what? 15. 15 plus 10 is 25, comma. That means this AP you can represent in this form: a comma a plus d comma a plus 2d comma a plus 3d. Okay, so this is just an example to explain you the general form of an AP. Okay, now next, this is a very important formula, and in 50% of the questions in this chapter, you will be using this formula. Okay, and this formula is about to find the nth term of an AP. Okay, what do you mean by nth term of an AP? For example, this is first term, second term, third term, fourth term. If you are asked what is the 799th term of this AP, okay, will you keep on writing up to 799? 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and all? No. Okay, it will take you a lot of time. So to directly find the 799th term of this AP, for example, you have to use this formula. Okay, and what is the formula? The formula is AN. N stands for nth term. Okay, if you want to find the 799th term, then you will write a 799, because nth n is 799. Okay, So an, that is nth term, is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. A very very simple formula to find any term in the in any finite or infinite AP. So this is the formula by which you can find the term that is present at any position in a in an infinite or finite AP. So the formula is an means nth term is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now what is a? A is the first term, d is the common difference. These two things we have already seen. An means nth term. So if I ask you to find 799th term, so this will be a 799, that means 799th term. So an is nth term. N is position of the term or total number of terms. Okay, so n stands for the position, like I said, 799th term. So that is the position of it. This is first term, second term, third term, fourth term. So A4 is fourth term. Okay. So N stands for position of the term or total number of terms. Okay. If you are told total number of terms are 10, that means you can write N is equal to 10, total number of terms. Okay. So you can use N for position of the term or total number of terms. Okay. Now one more variable. So these are different variables that are used: a, d, a, n, n, etc. Now last, similarly, one more variable l is used for what? Last term of an AP is denoted by l. Okay, the small l is used to denote the last term of an